Now the next assembly would be piston and articulated rod assembly. To start with this assembly, go to start mechanical design and assembly design workbench over here. We need to insert our two fully assembled components. The first one would be piston assembly, and second component would be fully assembled articulated rod that we need to insert in assembly workbench. Now to make these two parts coincide, we have to coincide the upper rod bushing axis with the piston pin axis. So select a coincident constraint over here, select the upper rod bushing axis and make it coincide with the piston axis. So if you update the figure, you can see articulated rod is in coincidence with the piston pin. Now we have to apply the offset constraint between this surface of the articulated rod and this surface of the piston, and the offset distance would be 4 mm each side. So if you update the figure, you can see articulated rod is fully assembled with the piston. The last thing that is required here is the angle. The articulated rod needs to be at the perpendicular with the piston, so we have to define angular constraint between these two surfaces and make the angle 90 degrees. If you update the figure, you can see articulated rod is fully assembled with the piston. We can save this assembly as. Piston and articulated rod assembly 1.